to my own business. Because after graduating or during the process of completing my master's in chemical engineering, pretty much I knew that I wasn't going to get a job because I had a friend, Kaisar Hassanji, who was a semester before me, was looking for a job for 6 months and couldn't get a job. So it was more the reason for me to do something for myself. And I find that many of us successful people or so-called successful people like to make stories about our own success after we become successful. But none of that is true with me. I had no plan, and I probably didn't have much of a vision because, you know, life doesn't really work the way after we get successful and we make our own story because it sounds sexy that we go, oh, I planned this and I did this. None of that was really true in my case. You know, I probably made best use of every opportunity that came in my way, and I was prepared for those opportunities. I guess that, in a nutshell, pretty much tells you what you need to do to achieve success, if there is such a thing. And I think this is just the beginning for my company, Awesome Products. You know, after 33 years of building a very solid company, we take very much pride in telling people that we are the only largest consumer products manufacturing company owned by an individual in the United States today. And we have no debt. It was all done. We don't owe any money to anybody. Actually, my family and me, we don't owe any money to anybody. I think I take it back. I haven't paid my bill at Radisson Blue yet. So probably before I leave, that's the only debt we have as a business people. Maybe it has to do with our middle class Maharashtrian upbringing, or we just managed our business in a way that we never had to borrow any money from anyone, and we are really proud of that. Today, we have grown our business with 400-500 associates, and we have plants in 3 different states, and we have grown all this organically, but now the growth is really going to start, and in coming 5 years, the model of growth is going to be acquisitions. So we just are going to close on a brine to bleach, salt to bleach plant, which is in New Haven, Connecticut, to support the density of population that is in Northeast, because United States is a very large country and freight is very expensive. I have plants in California, West Memphis, Arkansas, which covers the Midwest, and also in Mount Airy, North Carolina. But we were missing out the Canadian market and also the Northeast market. So this year we are closing on 2 plants. One is brine to bleach in New Haven, Connecticut, which makes about 60 million gallons of 12.5% bleach, which will convert some into household products and certain into supplying the municipalities for water purification. The second acquisition that we will be closing in December is Gympax. They are an ethoxylation and sulfonation company in Canada, and it's also in Toronto, Canada. So that will be another addition that we'll be adding to our business. So apart from growing the business organically to where we are in the last 33 years, with this mode of acquisition, we'll triple the size of the company in coming 3 to 4 years, and we are all very proud of that. You know, I know they are showing all these 6 guiding principles to achieve success in my life and all that. This was all created in the last 2 days, by the way. So don't pay too much attention to it. This all started primarily with how my upbringing was done. You know, I'm a guy who was born in Dhantoli, Nagpur. And then, this one Nagpur mein kehte the na, pula cha pahli kade, pula cha ali kade. First of 10 years I lived in Dhantoli, and then after that we used to live in medical college campus. And this becomes a second nature to somebody who wants to achieve things. But whenever there is some kind of an event organized like this, you know, everybody wants you to write down, you know, what is your principles of life and how did you achieve success. I mean, you got to go back and start talking to your friends, and then they tell you, oh, this is what you mean, right? And that's what it happens when you do it. But once you develop your way of life with absolute conviction as to what you want to do, the passion and the drive that you put into it, and the work ethic and the discipline that is given to you by your parents, your teachers, and also the knowledge. I wish I had studied a little more in LIT than what I did in those days. Because whatever I didn't study, I had to study back in the United States, because they don't really care there whether you know or you don't know, because if you don't know, they expect you to not come to the school. Whereas in here, it was different. We always used to think as if we are doing a favor to our teachers by going to the college. But those principles of life that really molded me, and I was very fortunate right from the beginning, when I was a little aggressive in our college days, when I was getting involved into our college elections and all, I had two mentors, which I would like to mention here today. One was Dattaji Didokar. He, probably many of you must have heard of his name. He was one of the finest human beings that was there for any young student who doesn't want to listen to his parents, but can act as your parent and guide you the right way. And the second person that always guided me was Jalpi Gini. I don't know if he's still around. He was one of the finest human beings that I still remember. Because in my college days, I had a tendency to get into trouble. And they were the guiding force, those who would always figure out a way and tell me that there is lot more bigger and better things that you can do in your life than just get consumed in student politics in the library. And I think my parents, of course, they wanted me to go to the United States, but I never wanted to leave Nagpur. These two people were the ones, those who told me that I should at least give it a try. And then, if you really become successful, you can always come back to Nagpur and do much better for your town. I guess it worked out. And I don't know whether it was luck or it was hard work, but whatever it is, I'm not complaining. It's in my favor, so I like it. You know, I was told by, yahan pe LIT ke kitne log hai bhai?
Oh,
awaaz lagao zara jo. You know, kai logon ne mujhe kaha yahan pe aake ki yaar LIT ke students aane wale hai, unko tumko kuch na kuch nasihat dena hai. तो ले यार मेरे से मैं तो सब कॉलेज में पता नहीं कितना रेगुलरली जाता था, पर एक चीज बहुत जरूरी है मालूम होना, और जो कि हमको दत्ता जी डेढ़ोकर बताते थे, जब तक अपनी सोच सच्ची हो, अपनी बुनियाद पक्की हो, अपनी चाहत ठोस से हो, और अगर दिल में अपने माता पिता के लिए भक्ति हो, तो कोई माई का लाल आपको तरक्की करने से रोक नहीं सकता है। और जिस दिन आप अपनी चाहत और अपने कर्मों के प्रति जो मोहब्बत है उसको कभी अगर इबादत में तब्दील कर दो, तो बच्चा जान ये जान लो कि आपकी और आपके साथ लगे हुए सभी लोगों की जिंदगी हमेशा हमेशा के लिए जन्नत बन के रहती है। और उसी के लिए तुमको 20-30 साल ऐसे लोग मिलते हैं जो कभी तुम्हारी कंपनी छोड़ना ही नहीं चाहते। तो ये दो चार चीजें जो नागपुर से सीखी थी, बस वही इस्तेमाल की, चल गई तो चल गई, ऐसा लगता है 33 साल जो चल गई तो आगे भी चल जाएगी। तो इससे ज्यादा और मैं तो कुछ नसीहत क्या, सलाह क्या, कुछ दे नहीं सकता हूँ, क्योंकि बिजनेस के बारे में यहाँ पे जो स्टेज पे बैठे हुए रफी महारथी है, इनको ज्यादा मालूम है। मेरे जैसे बोला खानदान में 90 साल में मैं पहला आदमी हूँ, तो मुझे ज्यादा कुछ समझता है नहीं, पर अगर आपको कुछ सवाल हो तो उसके जवाब देने की मैं कोशिश करूंगा। बस यही कहते हुए मैं अपना भाषण समाप्त करता हूँ।
सर,
After the very short interview, we stopped our Hardas. The floor is now open for questions from audience. All of you are requested not to ask two personal questions, political questions, and embarrassing questions.
मैं मेडिकल कॉलेज में था हरदास सिंह जो मदर है हरदास मैडम हमारे प्रोफेसर हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट इनको मैं बच्चे थे तब से मैं इनको देखा हुआ है आई एम सो मच इम्प्रेस्ड बाय स्पीच अभी मैं सोच रहा हूँ कि ये अभी बॉलीवुड में ट्राई करेंगे तो वहाँ पे भी बच्चे बढ़िया डायलॉग बोला आई वॉन्ट टू गिव वन बाय मिसेस सुलोचना पाटिल ऑल्सो एग्री विथ मी दैट यू शुड राइट सम बायोग्राफी
I am ever grateful to my mentor Arun Lanjewar sir for giving this opportunity. As well as I feel very honored via VIA that I am reading the same as you are. I have two questions going in my mind as a CEO personality. The first question is, you must have encountered lot many failures in your life. So how did you deal with those failures, those lows or those depression times? That is question one. And the question two that occurs is, as everybody here is an industrialist and works hard in life at the cost of his health, how did you maintain while working as an industrialist a perfect health? That is my question number two.
Health question तो बहुत आसान ही बताना तो उसको खत्म कर देते हैं। भाई सुबह उठ के कसरत करो, सब हो जाएगा ठीक आपको। Failures is a part of life. And actually, probably I had more times than I remember, I have failed, but the successes have made me go through all those failures much better. You know, there is no magic pill that anybody can give you, or I wish there was a Google Maps or app that can tell us, you know, aap ek, do, teen karo, aagaya success, right? Waisa to hota nahi hai. So this is a part and parcel of who we are. And I think the support from my parents, absolute support and faith, has always given me the strength that anything that can go wrong, I can always come back to it. My faith in my own religion, and it's for me, and I'm only speaking for myself, has given me a lot of strength. And last but not the least is, you know, when you look at, just look around you. There are so many people, those who are so happy without anything that they have. Those are the sources of strength that you can get from and really succeed. I hope I answered your question.
Anybody else?
How far Nagpur Management Association speaking gave you support? I'm also the student of
I think everything that I did, and you can't quantify a one thing in your life that give you the support or the strength and all that. It's always a cumulative things, right? It's like I told you, you know, those six principles that me and Arun drummed it up 2 days back is not the only thing that drives and guides you. I mean, main koi professor to hoon nahi, main koi consultant to hoon nahi ki bade bade graph leke aaya yahan pe ki ye karo wo karo aisa kar jata hai aisa kar jata hai aisa economy hoti hai aisa sab kuch hota nahi hai, right? So you have to base your judgment, your gut, and your ability to really drive yourself to want everything and win every single time. And you can do it. If you just fix your mind to it, it works. So I can't define that ye Nagpur Management Association ka course kiya to uske karan main yahan pahuncha, wahan pahuncha nahi. You know, hamare sir yahan baithe hue dealer sir, high school mein jab hum the, so he was the only one who had figured me out. Wo exam ke pehle, I never liked this stuff. structured way of judging people and students and telling you're smart, you're stupid, because you failed, because you passed. साल भर की पढ़ाई 3 घंटे में निकालना मेरे से तो होता नहीं था. तो वो हमेशा मेरे को कहते थे कि एग्जाम के पहले धीस टीच मी तबला, तबला बजा ले तेरा काम अच्छा हो जाएगा. एंड आई रियली टेल यू व्हेन एवर आई यूज्ड टू गो फॉर सर्टन एग्जाम्स आई यूज्ड टू रिलैक्स, बाकी किस लोग घोट रहे यू नो, और हम अपना तबला बजाते जाते थे, पास होके आ जाते थे.
Myself, being an entrepreneur like you, I always try to figure out that what in different conditions, like once you get success, you get relaxed. Once you get low position, you try to work hard. But how continuously you can get involved and keep the graph on it? Obviously, it's not going to up all the way. But how do you keep you engaged every time, even in case of success, even in case of failure? Because both failures comes like two sides of coin. It comes, keep coming. So how keep you keep myself engaged in this journey?
Motivation.
First thing is, you should not think of success and failure. That's not the way you run your life. That's a part of your life. Money is a byproduct of what you love to do in life, right? So once you stop giving importance to money, when you stop giving importance to success as is defined by our society, I mai janta hu ki abhi bhi apne samaj mein hamare izzat ka naap tol bazaru dhandalat se hi hota hai, right? Aur apni society bhi yahi kehti hai ki bhai jiske paas paisa hai usko salaam karo. Par ye sab bakwas hai. भाई अगर आप इसके बारे में सोचना बंद कर दो, बिल्कुल बंद कर दो कि भाई फेलियर क्या है, सक्सेस क्या है, खाली जो अपने दिल की बात है, अगर आपको दिल में लगता है कि ये सही चीज है तो उसमें लगे रहो. तो ये सब चीजों की कैसा पैशन इज व्हाट यू शुड ड्राइव बी ड्रिवन बाय, नॉट द सक्सेस और अ फेलियर, एंड दैट्स द की टू व्हाट यू डू इन लाइफ. आई थिंक सो.
यू आर सेटिंग अप अ प्लांट इन नागपुर. Can you tell us more about it?
Well, it's at a very preliminary stages. We have already started importing those over-the-counter drugs, and the investment that we are talking to some existing people in Nihar, and there is a lot more involved than just starting a plan, because we need it to be approved by the US FDA and all that. So it's a process that is going to take at least year and year and a half. But it is to manufacture over-the-counter drugs, which will be distributed under our brand. So the plant is only going to make what we sell under our brand to all the 30,000 retail stores in North America. So usko there hai, par andher nahi hai.
Yes, sir.
I'm Colonel Date. I am a Hardas alumni, and that's the reason I am here, number one. Number two, you just answered his question that we want to know what exactly is the nature of investment that you're going to have in Nagpur. Do you think that the type of difficulties that you are going to face here, are they going to be identical, or you when you open a new plant in US vis-a-vis the plant that you open in India for that matter, are there any difference in terms, like you said it will go to take a year and a half or so. I think it's a fairly long time as compared to what you probably would have it in the US as you're planning to open two plants. Can you just elaborate on that?
Well, opening up a plant in the United States, or every business process in the United States, is driven by the systems that are put in place, and we hardly need any human intervention in it. What I mean by that is, you know, it's very well defined. If you want to start a pharmaceuticals manufacturing, there is a book that is published, which is called Article 21. You read in it, and for every product, whether it is a prescription product or a household chemical product or over-the-counter product, there are processes that are very well defined. And then once you have done those, the inspectors will come. And it's a fairly clean system wherein if you do what you say and which you say what you do, usually you don't have any problems. Like I said, 90 years, nobody in my family is in business here. So I'll let you know once I find those problems. But the way the people in power here and the culture there, I don't think I'll have any issues of starting a plant in Nagpur.
Thank you.
Any more questions? Nobody wants to ask anything? Okay, I'll ask. Sir, सूत्रों से पता चला है कि आप सुबह 4 बजे उठ के फैक्ट्री जाते हैं। ये बताइए कि आप ये करते कैसे? And day in and day out, every day you're doing it.
आदत से मजबूर है, और कुछ आता नहीं करने को, तो बस सुबह उठ जाते
हैं। 4 बजे?
कभी-कभी उसके पहले भी उठ जाता हूँ, सुन जाता हूँ। It's primarily because, you know, I'm not a control freak, but I want to know what is going on in my plants. So in the United States, we have 3 hours difference. So my plant in North Carolina, when they start at 6 o'clock in the morning, it's 3 o'clock in California. So, you know, that's when I try to find out if everything is going well, you know, everything fired up well or not. And, you know, it's just because I started my own business, so I'm pretty much involved. Not that they need me or I can do any difference, but it's just my habit. So, you know, ये सब चीजें को ड्रम अप करने की कोई जरूरत है नहीं, वो न मेरे एम्प्लॉयज को मेरी जरूरत है, न किसी को मेरी जरूरत है, बस मेरे को ही जरूरत है कि सुबह उठ के पूछना करके मैं करता हूँ।
You
know, so LA is totally awesome is a brand which is an organically grown brand which we promoted with my friends, and for that reason I was very lucky to start a business when this deep discount stores called dollar stores like Macon Brock, who was my mentor, and Dave Gold, which you saw in the film, they were the founding fathers of our dollar store industry, which is no longer a dollar, they sell more than a dollar, but they were all starting their retail businesses at the same time, and they had nobody else who could supply them products at such cheap prices. So by supplying them the best quality, extreme value, and then the price came at the end, you know, the quality was first, people started using our product and it grew accordingly. But then I bought a brand from Unilever, Rinzo, which was a laundry detergent, largest selling laundry detergent in the United States from 1910 to 1960, and then Unilever discontinued that brand in the United States. So I took over and I revived it, and there were still people who remember that. So we started buying brands. The second brand that I bought from Helene Curtis, which is also Unilever, for Vibrance and ThermaSilk, which is the shampoo brand that we bought. So now acquiring brands is probably going to give us a little more volume and sales to our business. Acquiring companies will be an easier way, because 33 years is a long time to grow where we are, and if I don't have another 33 years to work. So in order to grow this to triple or quadruple the size, we have to grow with acquisition, and that's the route now we are going to take. And that's where this manufacturing in Nagpur and all that is going to come. And it will help market more product in our stream of commerce.
Thank you.
I have one question. Like you said, you were dealing all your life with like Walmart and all the other deep discount stores. But it has been said that they are very, like, they don't allow their suppliers to earn. They are very ruthless with the pricing and all. So how you are, like, deal with them and still grow your company?
Well, I don't blame them because I'm the same way when it comes to my suppliers. You know, we got my friend here, Gaurav Agrawal. He's from Nagpur and he supplied over 40 crore bheja, right? 40 crore laundry detergent cash. So America ke 40 crore log Nagpur wale ki cap. You know, it's the nature of the business. Nobody wants anyone to take advantage of each other. But people, and smart business people, they know where the value is and where the quality is. And there is a threshold that you can do. And one of the reasons I'm known to be the lowest cost producer is because we have no debt. Most of the companies in my space have more debt than their sales. So, हमारे को चार लोगों के फैमिली को खाने को जितना मिलता है उतना कमा लिया, तो अभी भी अपन थिंकिंग वही है ना यार, मराठी ब्राह्मण लोग क्या करेंगे? कोई ज्यादा मंगता नहीं है. So, price and quality, though they are all tied together, I don't think there is anybody who can make anything better than awesome products in the United States right now.
actually I used to call him Sarang, you know. I have a very interesting episode. He used to live in the same place where I live now. In the sense that has been converted, Tanjurkar Bungalow has been converted into a flat scheme. So today I realized just after coming here that he is the same Sarang, you know. So once in Bair or Jam, ke liye patthar bhi mara karte the. He was a naughty boy. But nonetheless, I have a very serious question. And the serious question is, what is your future succession plan? Because in family business particularly, we notice that it's really a challenge and people neglect succession planning. So our people will be very delighted to know, okay, what are your objectives about, or what are your plans for succession?
She's in kitchen. What a problem hai. Idhar mein apne mata pita jo bolte the, wo gap chap sunte the aur karte the. अमेरिका में थोड़ा अलग होता है. अपने बच्चों को उनकी सोच और उनकी समझ जरा ज्यादा होती है. वो डिपार्टमेंट में अभी थोड़े कच्चे हैं हम, पर कोशिश जारी है कि दो बेटे हैं, शायद एक को वकील बनना है और एक यहाँ बैठी है, तो अभी वो 20 साल की है तो उसको थोड़ा मैनिपुलेट कर सकता हूँ, शायद उसको बिजनेस में ला सकूं. पर नहीं हुआ तो अभी भी दमखम बाकी है और 10-12 साल तो खींचेंगे देंगे, बाद में पता नहीं क्या होगा.
सर कुछ नहीं हुआ तो हम किसी को अडॉप्ट कर लीजिए.
एनी अदर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द ऑडियंस?
यस सर, मैं सर डॉक्टर वासे. आई केम इन टू कॉन्टैक्ट विद मिस्टर लोकसान सरदार इन लास्ट 1.5 years. And one of the very important thing that I would like to highlight about this great person is that he's not only an excellent businessman, professional, high quality, but he has a very high respect for his relationship, for friendship, and also emotion. And that I have realized when I came into contact with him. Because whenever people become entrepreneurs or businessmen, they keep all these things away from them, friendship, emotions, relations, and then they become true businessmen. But in case of Loksaran Hardas, I have seen that he has a policy of he learned here, he earned here, and now he is in phase of returning it to the society. So that is the best thing that I have seen. He has high respect for his parents, because when I came into contact with him, we as the Indian Medical Association wanted to build an annex building in our campus. So he came forward, and for only one reason, that he had very high respect for his parents. And his father was our past president of Indian Medical Association, and his mother taught us microbiology in medical college. He got married there in Indian Medical Association. And he used to say, okay, whenever my father used to work in IMA as the president, they were always there playing in the campus. And so he has decided then to help us, and he really helped us to bring up this building. These are the values that we should have. And sometimes it becomes conflict when you become a businessman, how to maintain friendship, how much your relationship, and how much you should be emotional. I think Sir Loksaran should guide the young entrepreneurs here regarding that. Thank you.
Any more questions? Young entrepreneurs? Aspiring entrepreneurs?
Please. I have one question to you, sir. Whenever it comes to the growth of the business, especially when you are starting off, it's very difficult phase of our life. And when you are growing, as you said, you know, your parents were your first helping hands in the United States. So when once you decided to grow your company business, how did you go about recruiting more people, you know, who would stay with you forever, it seems from the film. So what is the secret of managing people or selecting people at that point?
I think there is no secret. We all pretty much know what you need to do. When you hire people, you have to look within you, what do you want for yourself? And when you give that same things that you want in your life to people that work around you. You know, initially, I was told by my mentors in the business, that in the United States there are three things that are most important for anybody that comes to work for you. One is home, where they live. Second is car. And third is health insurance, because these are the most three expensive things. So if anybody would come to work for me, you know, we used to, I first bought an apartment complex and I used to give them a place to live for free. And if they would come to work, I would buy them a car. And building loyalty is a two-way stream. You can't just expect people to work for you and hope they do everything that you want, and in return you don't give them anything. So, and the consistency in expecting loyalty goes back to an employer also, in what you give back to your employees. And when you define their purpose in your own company is not just to make money for yourself and earn a salary, but how they are making a difference in other people's lives. You know, I would take them to the stores, because most of the stores where we sell our products are shopped by people, those who are not very rich, or I would say not very smart, because our quality is better than national brand equivalent. So when they see the value that they create, and when they see the products that are being bought by other common people, they feel proud of it. And that's, it's a team building, you know. ये सब यहीं से सीखा था यार एलआईटी में तीनों साल इलेक्शन चुन के आए थे तो यार दोस्त कैसे जमा करना सब नाटक नहीं सीखे वही इस्तेमाल किया वहां पे अब बड़ी बड़े शब्दों में बताऊंगा तो आप और कंफ्यूज हो जाओगे कुछ जो आपको अच्छा लगता है आपको जो चाहत है वही दूसरे को दो तो सब आपके साथ चलेंगे
You said that your company is debt-free company. So in the initial years when the business required some money, how did you put the capital into it?
Well, I never spend more than what I earn. And, you know, I'm a very creative guy when it comes to manufacturing your own equipment. I was the best stainless steel welder. And as you know, in our processing industry, you need to know how to do the welding. And, you know, in first year of our chemical engineering, we used to have that machine shop, which we never liked to go there and all. So I learned, after going to the United States, how to run a lathe. So I got good with my hands, and I created value for my own business. And I think it is the upbringing that was there too, you know. Paisa baro karna, badi takleef hoti thi. So bas idhar udhar se, kabhi customer se thoda advance le liya, kabhi vendor se financing kar liya. उसमें काम चला लिया मे बी आई वाज जस्ट लकी आई डोंट नो बट इट ऑल वर्क्ड आउट वेरी वेल और हो सकता है
यस
सर नमस्कार मराठी के अनुसार आधा प्रश्न असा होता सर की तुम्ही बी म्हणजे इंजिनिअरिंग नागपुरात नाही केलं भारतात नाही केलं त्यानंतर पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएशन करायला तुम्ही अमेरिकेत गेले त्यावेळेस तुम्ही आता सांगितलं की भारतामध्ये ज्यावेळेस एल आय टी वन ऑफ द प्रेस्टिजियस इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ नागपूर इवन सेंट्रल इंडिया तिथून इंजिनिअरिंग करताना तुम्हाला म्हणजे तुमचे जे सिनियर होते त्यांना नोकरी मिळू शकली नाही मग त्याच्यानंतर मग तुम्ही अमेरिकेत गेले तिथे तुम्ही अमेरिकेतलं शिक्षण बघितलं अमेरिकेत शिकले आणि तिथे तुम्ही नोकरीच्या ऐवजी तुम्ही व्यवसायाला प्राधान्य दिलं मला हे विचारायचं आहे सर की भारतातलं शिक्षण आणि अमेरिकेतलं शिक्षण या दोघांमध्ये तुम्हाला काय फरक जाणवला पहिला आणि दुसरा की भारतातही तुम्ही आजही तुम्ही आता नागपुरात सुरू करणार आहात सगळं काम नागपुरातल्या लोकांना तुम्ही प्राधान्य देणार आहात तुम्ही ऑब्झर्व केलं असेल की इथल्या लोकांमध्ये एम्प्लॉयबिलिटीसाठी काय स्किल्स आवश्यक आहेत तर मला दुसरा प्रश्न हा आहे की अशा कुठल्या स्किल्स आम्हाला नागपुरातल्या लोकांना विद्यार्थ्यांना आवश्यक आहेत ज्या आम्हाला एम्प्लॉयबल बनवतील इव्हन व्यवसायाच्या दृष्टिकोनातून आणि नोकरीच्या दृष्टिकोनातून सुद्धा
ओके तर पहिले तुम्ही विचारलं की आपल्या एज्युकेशन सिस्टीम मध्ये काय फरक आहे आता हे मला जे वाटतं ते सांगतो काही जण डिसअग्री करतील तर करे द्या मला बरं पडलं बेसिक फरक मला जो वाटला की आपल्या इथे सगळ्या गोष्टीची उत्तरं तुम्हाला असायला पाहिजे असतात जेव्हा आपण आपला एक्झाम सुद्धा देत असतो त्याच्यामध्ये त्या गणिताचं संपूर्ण उत्तर जर दिलं नाही तर युजली तुम्हाला मार्क मिळत नाही त्याच्या उलट अमेरिकेमध्ये तुमचा अप्रोच काय होता त्या गणिताला सॉल्व्ह करायचा आणि त्याला तुम्ही कम्प्लीट जर करू नाही शकलात तरी त्याला तितकं प्राधान्य दिलं जायचं नाही. जर तुम्हाला ते गणित काय आहे आणि त्याचं सोल्युशन कुठल्या प्रोसेसनी येणार आहे हा तुमचा अप्रोच जर त्या शिक्षकाला कळला तर ते तुम्हाला मार्क जितके पाहिजे तितके मिळायचे. तर तो एक बेसिक फरक मला तिथे वाटला. आणि दुसरं तिथे तुम्हाला जर जरूरत असेल तर तुम्ही शिकायला या. आपल्या इथे कसं की शिक्षकांना आपण असं धरून चालतो की त्यांना जरूरत आहे आपल्याला शिकवायची, आपल्याला जरूरतच नाही. बापांनी पाठवलं गेले झालं ठीक आहे, नाही झालं तर बंद करा, सिनेमा पाहायला जा, गॅदरिंग आहे, हे आपल्याला